In the past few years, I have observed that parents have a lot of expectations from their children. This high expectation leads to a lot of pressure on the child. So I remember once there was one of the students of mine who was very artistic and very creative. So when she got her file to me, I was surprised to see the kind of work that she had come up with. I generally asked her if she would like to pursue art because she was so good in it. But then she disappointingly said, "No, I would not, because my parents want me to go abroad and study MBBS so that I can be a doctor." So I generally asked her, why does she feel so? If she doesn't want to go in for it. Because then later it came to us, when we talked to the parents, we came to us that their friends and their friend's daughter had been abroad and now is a doctor there. So they also wanted their child to go and settle in the same way as the other family had. This kind of an expectation leads to a lot of internal pressure on the child, a lot of internal expectations to meet up to the parents' demand. And this doesn't lead to healthy, happy life. It doesn't lead to a healthy competition as well. So in order to develop a healthy competition, we need to bring in what the child feels, what the child wants. No matter whether it is photography or whether it is art or whether it is painting or whether it is MBBS, it should be a child's defined line, what he or she wants in his life, because that is what is ultimately going to keep him or her happy. And once the child chooses what he or she wants, I'm sure the child will be able to live up to the expectations of the parents of doing well and also being satisfied and earning well for him or herself. As a psychologist, while I'm doing career counseling sessions with children, we allocate and we decide upon the streams, and then when we have meetings with the parents, I can see the kind of rigor and the force that they come up with when they want their child to be in a particular stream, even when the tests do not agree with it or support it. So this kind of a pressure on a child will never be able to bloom the internal quality of the child. It will never be able to bring out that core of the child which the child has actually been blessed with. If we allow the child to go into the stream that he or she wants to, I'm sure the creativity, the happiness and the perfection will come in on its own, and the child will automatically go ahead in success in his life. So allowing the child to be is one good formula for the child to have a happy life. There have been several incidences where I have seen that the child has always curbed his or her need of being what he or she wants to be, but has never been able to openly come up and talk about it. So we have to give space as parents, that open space of communication, to allow the child to say what he or she wants. Because ultimately it is not our expectations as parents, it is the child's expectation and his or her life that he will be taking up further with. Forcing our own decisions, forcing our own wills, forcing our own fancies on the child will not be a right idea to give a holistic development to the child. Hence, giving him or her his way will always help the child to be in the best situation, have a good coping mechanism and deal with anything that comes by in his or her life. All that I am saying is not only from a perspective of a psychologist, it's also from, yes, of course, from the theories that we have studied, from the knowledge that we have gained over the time, but also from what we have seen and observed around us. Also as a teacher, dealing with each student on a daily basis, so many students on a daily basis, and also as a mother of two kids, wherein I see on every moment, allowing the child helps the child come closer to you. That love and the bond is totally different from that dominance that we show on the child. Giving a democratic, a little permissive, a little firmness in a balanced way will always help the child to bloom in his own different way, which will be a story in itself later in life, which you or you as a parent and child both will cherish.